viewers, welcome to our YouTube channel. I am Manan Gaur from Pacific College of Engineering, and I am with the presentation on classes and objects. Before going any further, let's understand the concept of process-oriented programming and object-oriented programming. In C programming language, we were using the concept of process-oriented programming, which actually meant that we are focusing how to implement program into code. But with C++, the object-oriented programming concept is introduced, which means that we are focusing on the real-world entities and how they can be programmed into system. And this is all about the object-oriented and process-oriented programming. Now let's move on to the concept of classes and objects. Classes are the collection of data members and member function. And for the skeletal structure that a class has provided, objects are the memory allocators, means they allocate the memory for the skeletal structure which is provided by the class. Here it's an object, here it's a class, this is a skeletal structure, and here it's this object. This object is allocating memory for these all things. How to define a class? How to make a class in a program? A class always begins with the keyword class, followed by name of the class, starting brace, and here it is its ending brace with the termination symbol. It begins with the access specifier private. These are the data members. Because it's an access member private, it cannot be accessed by the main program itself. It requires the member function to provide access to these data members. So now we are taking the inputs. Inputs are in the public section, so they can access these data members A and B, which could be used in the main program. The benefit of this access specifier is that it cannot be edited by external entities, hence saved from accidental additions or accidental deletions or something, anything like that. So we take an input function, we define two inputs A and B, and this function is over at here. In the output function, we are just returning the addition. We create an object, some object. Object is calling the input function from here. This A and B are called, and this A and B are inputted into this object. This entity is done here. Now this object function calls the output. This output function in this object returns the addition. The program is done over here. It was a basic program how to add two entities using objects and classes. So guys, to understand this concept in a better method, let's take a real world example. You are a market to buy some fruits. So what would constitute as an object? The object would be like the fruit names: apple, oranges, and grapes. Data members will constitute prices, quantity, and qualitative analysis. Member function will constitute the total price calculation and the logic to buy it or not. Let's understand it, how it will work. In the program, you will define three objects: apple, oranges, and grapes. According to the prices given by the shopkeeper, you will now arrange the data like prices of apple, quantity of apple, prices of oranges, quantity of oranges, price of grapes, quantity of grapes. Then you will apply the logic, how to bargain, buy it or not, qualitative analysis, are the fruits are in good shape or are of bad quality. That will come in logic to buy it or not. In the end, the logic that would be applied is total price calculation, the payment that you will do to the shopkeeper. Thank you guys for watching our video. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And please remember to comment. I hope it helped you.